Yep, we got a red fox here in our blind set and the trails along the riverbank we've been setting. We've got about 3 traps here. We found a fox den up here and they're coming down here on the riverbank, and we found the trails they've been running, and we set some blind sets in the trails, and looks like we've got a nice red follow us up.
I am digging.
Got me a nice red fox here this morning on the Oak River again in a blind trail set where they've been running through here. Looks like a real good prime fur. We're going to get rid of them out of the trap and we'll get back with you. Grunt Gobble Go Outdoors. Stick with us.
Hey everyone, we got the fox out of the trap. It's a real pretty male. Wintertime reds on the Oak River. Beautiful fox. Nice prime fur pelt. Couldn't ask for a better fur. It's real good and prime. So stick with us as the trap line continues here in 2013/2014. Grunt Gobble Go Outdoors.
See, I want to keep my trap as low as I can, because when he comes in here, I want him to, if he don't get caught, I want him to be able to dig and dig out. I don't want him to dig straight back and pull my trap out of the ground. That's what a lot of people's complaining about, because they're having a lot of trouble. They're getting their trap too high on the ground and they're kicking their traps out because it's an object they feel. They don't know it's a trap. It's just an object like this. They'll just move it out of the way and then go after your bait. And you think, I got a smart digger on my hands. No, not really. It's just something different to him, and he didn't want it there, and he could feel it. And it wasn't he dug you out. He felt it. But he'll get it figured out in time. We've all been through them stages. Trying to get me a little bit of wax paper here. My hands are dry. I can touch a lot of stuff when I'm dry. You don't want to touch your stuff when you're wet, because that will leave an odor on it. A couple days it'll go away. You can catch your fox or a coyote that way. But right now we're in warm temperatures coming out of zero weather. The ground froze. I don't like to use a whole lot of wax paper. I like to just have enough to set over my trap pan. And a lot of times I don't use wax paper. Well, that's all well and good, but I'm an earth man, and I like peat moss, but I like to use it in these temperatures we're using but I also like to put my top in the dirt back on my trap, because that's bringing it back to that dirt hole set. Just skim it a little bit, you know. Make this box just set. Because when they dig all this stuff up and they kick it out here behind them a lot of times when they're digging. It don't hurt to blend her right back in. Now we're gonna put a little bit of bait in here. Some of Chris's specialty bait he made up. I like it well. That should be about enough. A lot of people says, why you touch that bait? Well, I'd rather have it on my hands and have it on my gloves and have them dig my trap up. And they're not gonna smell that. You know, sometimes you can go a little too far with stuff. I used to do it myself. We're gonna punch that bait back in that hole. Okay, I think that's a fine set. We'll just clean her up a little bit here. I might just use a little bit of a different gland lure. It's good to break your sets up. I've been using a number, Violator 7. On mostly all my fox sets and coyote sets. I'm after my coyotes now. You gotta break your sets up some. You set everything the same way, you don't get no critters. They may come to your sets and then walk away. You may have caught a couple things on it, which that happens. It's happened to me this year. I've caught several reds on it, you know, but I'm getting late in the season now, and they're after more odors than anything. They like gland lures and urine, and that's what you're going to catch a lot of your stuff on right now. These bait hole sets and this urine and stuff, it's you got a variety of stuff out there. And now we're going to set a lot of scent post sets and see how we can do on that. We haven't set none this year. This is our first day at it. We've got several of these out, and we've done good on them. We're gonna get us a little ball here. All I like to do is get me a stick, and you don't need a whole cotton ball. And what you want to do is you want to make you like a Q-tip. Spin it around there, and this stuff, you shake it well. I'm going to use a long distance. It's called a 600, and it's a louder lure. They come in 100, 500. And what I want to do is I want to dip that in there. And you can see what I've got right there. That'll be good for about 3 or 4 days, and you never know, you might have your fox go up here tonight and get him in there. And you clean your sets back up, you ain't got to put it back in there. I like to just take it right back here, and I want him to come in there, and I want to put it right in that hole right there. And tonight, I'm not going to put no urine there. I'm just going to go with some bait and some gland lure. I'm switching different things, going different directions today. It's I'm on a new farm. You can see it, it's God's country. I've had my son Chris up here turkey hunting a lot when he was little. And it's huge. It's more than we've got, what we've got to trap, but we take it all. Every bit of it. So we'll move on to the next set.
Got a double here. Got a nice coon right here, and I got a possum out here. Come on up here and check it out. Real nice big boar coon. Got a good hold on in that offset number 3. Nice one. Nice coon. Let's go up here and look at the possum. And we got a little old possum. Might just go ahead and turn him loose and let him grow up another year. His fur ain't real big, he's just a little old thing. We'll go ahead and turn him loose and let him go. We'll catch him next year. Stick with us. Grunt Gobble Go Outdoors.
Well, this makes a second coon this morning. Huh. He's a black and darky. He's these little ones. You can pet them. I would advise you reach down, Patty. But they like to be scratched a little bit. They're little ones. Huh. Well, it's time to go and trap some more traps. Check some more traps. Got tongue tied there. A little bit excited. We've come through a hard freeze, and it's been tough on us this last week. And it finally broke. Last night, we got a nice big boar coon. We got this one, and we got several other traps to go check. So we're gonna get rid of this one, and we're gonna head on out of here. See you in a little bit.